The 3D preview is a new way to visualize your laser setup in 3D and allows you to implement valuable data into your projectors and setup, like XYZ position data, for later reference. The 3D preview window can be found under View 3D Preview. This window, in the top bar, has the normal new open and save functions within the file menu. This 3D preview is a separate file to your zones, hardware lists, and workspace. You can also export the setup to CSV and import from CSV. This allows for manual typing of all data points of lasers and importing them directly, or exporting a setup with reference data. Under Tools is where you can enable the Settings panel on the right, the command line, and enable camera rotating around objects and center. Let's make sure all of these are enabled for this video. In this main window, you will see your 3D environment. Each environment comes with a basic setup of four walls, a floor, and a mesh screen. All your lasers will be placed somewhere within this 3D preview. In the right area, you will see the settings panel. This is where all the settings for your setup will be. First, we have the room itself. In this menu, you have access to overall settings, including the room light and fog intensity. The room size for XYZ, otherwise known as length and width and height. You can enable or disable the origin point, and you can modify textures or enable and disable the textures for each surface. Next, we have the Gause screen. This acts as a transparent to opaque surface you can place in your space to use for graphics, but also the Gause screen can be used to place in front of your lasers so you can see the drawn pattern from each laser and the 3D output at the same time. The Gause screen can be adjusted below, with its visibility, also known as opacity, its position in the room, its rotation, and its size. From there, you have projectors. The amount of projectors you have here will be the same as you have in your hardware list, and the index number of those projectors will also match. This is how you can tie your real-life setup, your zone file, and hardware into one big setup. If you don't currently have the lasers connected, utilize demo projectors in the hardware list. Each projector can be placed with an X, Y, and Z position, as well as an X, Y, and Z rotation. You can also set the scan angle on the laser and the projector brightness. From there, your zoning within your zone file will take effect. Just set the scan angle to be what you'd normally might see in the field. A safe bet is 60 degrees. If you have a lot of lasers in your setup with varying power levels, you can also change the projector brightness so you can see some groups brighter than others. Now let's discuss actually setting up your preview. There are three main ways. The first is just select one laser at a time and move them within 3D space. This can be accomplished by dragging the laser within the space and pulling and pushing on the XYZ arrows. This is intuitive, but time-consuming. You can save a little time by selecting multiple projectors from the list above and then move them all at once. The second option is to utilize the sliders and number entry points in the settings panel to achieve a similar situation. You can select a group, move them towards the back of the room, maybe angle them all at once, and then select one at a time to move them from left and right to create your setup. The final and fastest way, if you get the hang of it, is to utilize the command line. A few simple codes could lead to quick setup, like this code that'll evenly space a group of lasers. Type SEL126POSX-5 to 5. This will place lasers 1 to 6 from negative 5 to position 5 on the x-axis. A full list of commands and examples can be found on screen or at the wiki for full documentation. Thanks for watching this quick hints video on the new 3D preview window inside of Pannel 5.5. If you still need help, feel free to contact support@pangolin.com or check out the wiki at wiki.pangolin.com for full written documentation.